And of course, we can't talk about climate change and dry forest and wildfire season without talking about why the climate is changing. And I'm curious, you know, what Congress is doing, can be doing to be cutting greenhouse gas emissions.
Yeah. You know, one of my biggest frustrations is how much time we spend arguing about the hardest to decarbonize sectors instead of viewing our job as current policymakers as really accelerating the stuff that we already know how to do. Like, we know how to do most of the things that are going to clean up our atmosphere, and we need to do them a lot faster. And so my hope is that some of the things around, for example, decarbonizing, switching to electrification in homes and businesses, as our electric sector is already decarbonizing itself, can really accelerate our progress on these things.
So these are really hard times and scary times for New Mexicans, and I feel like in general for Americans. What sort of, you know, and it's not like our fire seasons are going to get easier or our water challenges are going to get easier. And I'm curious, you know, what kind of hope there might be or solutions there might be.
The good news is there are a ton of solutions. If we just focus on this and lead and implement, there is so much that can be done to protect our landscapes, protect our communities, change the way that we do energy in this country and around the world. And you know, not being able to lead and make decisions, that's the real jeopardy. The more we do now, the better life is going to be for our kids and grandkids.
And, you know, I'm curious because I think a lot of times we look to federal leadership because, you know, the federal government does drive innovation and investment, but also things really, especially environmental issues, it seems like get tangled up in politics. And so I'm wondering what sort of local action or local uprisings need to be occurring.
Well, I would urge people, get involved with your school board. I mean, get involved with your local city council, with your county commission. There are all sorts of action that can be taken to drive these things forward. And, you know, every different level of government has a budget that they can use to get us there faster. How we build our buildings, how we, you know, replace furnaces with things like heat pumps that will actually return an enormous amount to the taxpayers, as they're so much more efficient than the way we have been heating our buildings. So there are a lot of opportunities that have nothing to do with federal policy. And certainly at the state level as well, we have great legislators who are pushing forward on things like clean fuels and incentives to speed up the rate at which we decarbonize. And, you know, that's exactly what we should all be focused on right now, because right now we can still, you know, it's not going to be easy going forward, but the more we do, the easier it's going to be.
And just lastly, you know, you're someone who appreciates New Mexico's landscapes and your father. And I just wonder what keeps you up at night that maybe we're not addressing or that we might be losing at this point.
You know, just the sense of how much of New Mexico changed in this fire season that will not look the way that I know it in my lifetime, probably not my kids' lifetime either. That's a lot, but all the more reason to get to work.